What's good, everybody? It's your girl, Lady Red, and I'm back with another video. Happy hump day, everybody. Okay, you guys, I have some chicken thighs here and some mac and cheese because I am doing my boy Debo Vibes and his twin brother, The Thinker's first challenge. Well, I think it's The Thinker's first challenge collab with Debo Vibes, and it's called the My Sweet Thigh Challenge. So the rules are you have to have some chicken thighs, of course, a side, and you have to drizzle it with something sweet. I have honey, and you have to mention your favorite club spot, your favorite club song, and challenge three people. I have my Sprite and my glass of ice on the side, so let's get into it. No click. It didn't make the pop sound, you guys, because I had opened it already. Let me get my sippy sip. This chicken is looking good. I'm gonna hop on into it, you guys. How are you guys doing? If you are new here, welcome. If you've been here before, welcome back. Get some honey on this bad boy. Oh my God, my mouth is watering for this. So, let me see. And I was called out by Cindy's Journey. You guys, go over there and check out Cindy's Journey. She's super cool. I love her energy, her vibe. So, the club scene, huh? All right, so it's 2004. And I was hitting the clubs pretty hard then. I'm not really a club person, but I was going often back then. And the spot that I was going to was called, or is called because it's still open, Webster Hall. And Webster Hall is located in Manhattan. It's in the Village. And the song that I played while getting ready for the club will be Drop It Like It's Hot by Snoop Dogg. When I got to the club. Oh, as a matter of fact, let me mention this part about Webster Hall. The dope part about Webster Hall is that they had several floors. They had four floors that played specific genres of music, and they had, of course, the hip-hop rap floor. They had the reggae floor, the techno floor, and the R&B floor. Oh my God, yo, this shit was mad dope. Like, it was so fun going there, like hopping from floor to floor, enjoying yourself. I stayed on the reggae floor and the hip-hop floor, but when I was there, 2004, Christina Milian's song, Dip It Low, was out. And that was my banger. I love that song. Like, the way it sounded in the club, the bass, the beat, it was just really good. It's a sexy song, and I really enjoyed myself dancing to that song in the club. My after song, when I was coming home, when I got home, would be Lean Back by Terror Squad. But dip it low. Oh my God, you couldn't tell me nothing. I was in the club. This is when I was a little smaller and I used to belly dance. So, child, I was doing my thing in the club. Doing my thing. But Webster's Hall was a pretty dope club to be in. I think that it's cool that they have different floors with different music, different genres. It's not like a club that just plays everything. You can go to the second floor if you're into techno. Go to the third floor if you into reggae. The first floor was hip hop. Super dope. This particular time I had went, I think we were celebrating somebody's birthday. I can't remember. But Dip It Low came on and I went crazy, and so did the niggas. Not to toot my own horn, but toot toot. I don't have any crazy crazy stories, except for like one guy thought he was gonna follow me home. Had to dead that. No, we dancing in the club and that's it. Sometimes dudes be going crazy. You give them a little dance and then they think they supposed to come home with you. I don't know, maybe some women, some people get down like that, so they are used to that, or they expect that. I don't know, but I don't have any crazy stories. That's my story. I love when Dip It Low came on. My pre-club song, like I said, was Drop It Like It's Hot. The after song, Lean Back. But I really enjoy going to Webster Hall. Anybody from New York know about Webster Hall? You know that's a pretty dope club. They have so many good club songs. It's hard to choose. But Dip It Low was when I lost my mind to when it came on. Alright, so I'm supposed to tag three people. I'm going to tag let me see. I think Tag for short. Tag for short. Bayou Kitchen Guy. Who else? Nadira Eats. So, Tag for short, Bayou Kitchen Guy, and Nadira Eats. You've been tagged. I want to hear your club story, club bangers. Nowadays, well, not nowadays, but before 2020, and you guys know what I'm talking about, I kind of, even now, I just even when, like, I can't talk. This chicken is so good. I'm not really into the club scene anymore. Now I'm a little more laid back. I like the lounges, the bar. Go to the hookah spot. I know there was this one club that I went to. It was called Club Duvet. And you guys know what a duvet is, right? This spot had beds, like, in the club. When I went, nobody was doing anything. People were just lounging on the bed, relaxing, chilling, drinking, doing what they do. But it was called Club Duvet. And it had, I think that area was like more or less VIP. But Club Duvet, it had beds in it. I didn't fuck around with the bed. I stayed at the bar. Excuse me. That was good. All right, you guys, I'm done. I'm full. This was pretty cool, reminiscing and going back into the day of my club days. Really cool. The My Sweet Thigh Challenge. Tag for short, Bayou Kitchen Guy, and Nadira Eats. You guys have been tagged. Debo and the Thinker, thanks for this cool challenge. I appreciate it. Thank you, Cindy's Journey. Excuse me. For tagging me in it. But alright, you guys, I'm about to get up out of here. If you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up. Don't forget to comment, subscribe, and share, guys. Sharing is caring, so do me that solid and share. Hit that notification bell so you'll be notified every time I upload a video. Thank you for watching. I'm Lady Red, and I'm out.